When I was just a wee little lad, I remember loving but also being afraid of zombies. Dead people rising from their graves to feast on the flesh of the living, missing eyes, jaws, or just plain gory and disfigured, always haunting my dreams. But in a good way. The first horror movie I ever saw was the original Night of the Living Dead on a horror collection DVD that also had an episode from Tales from the Crypt called An All Through the House, and that was scary as hell as a kid as well. But now I enjoy it to simply watch some good old-fashioned horror comedy. Loved this show as a kid. When 28 Days Later came out in theaters in 2002, I was about 8 or 9, so I didn't really get to see it till it came out on DVD. When I got it, and I saw it, all I could say is it was awesome as hell. I admit, I was a little freaked out about the fact that these once shambling zombies are now running at full sprint trying to get you. Gone were the scared of fire traits and being able to walk around a few of them. Now they came at you with a vengeance and a hunger for flesh. Okay, before I get ahead of myself, let's start at the beginning. The film stars Cillian Murphy as Jim, a comatose man who wakes after 28 days after the initial outbreak of the Rage virus, a virus that turns anyone infected into mindless, angry, and violent people that really don't eat people as much as beat them to a pulp and infects others. He ventures into the desolate land that was Great Britain in a shot that is still pretty awesome to look at, and sets the tone and atmosphere of the movie quickly and effectively. He walks into a church and sees a mass of piled bodies. When he yells hello, two of the bodies get up and stare at him, mouth agape. First time I saw that, I gotta admit, I started laughing because of how they looked, with their mouths open and the red eyes. But then he sees a priest and asks him for help, but he beats him up instead after he comes after him.
Oh, I shouldn't have done that.
He runs and is saved by Selena, played by Naomi Harris, and Mark, played by Noah Huntley. From there, the group discuss what happened in the time that Jim was in his coma, that a virus spread, first to small towns, then to a massive scale that ended up causing a societal collapse and the fall of the government. Later, they go to Jim's parents' house to find out if they survived, but no, they didn't. They decide to rest up there for the night, but are then attacked by infected after Jim lights up candles and watches his old home movies. Mark is bitten, and Selena ends up killing him, telling Jim that she'll do the same to him in a heartbeat. It's here that we learn that the infection works fast and has an infection time of up to 10 to 20 seconds before a person is turned into a psychotic monster. Later, they find another pair of survivors, a father and daughter named Frank and Hannah. They turn on a radio and find a pre-recorded broadcast calling any survivors to meet near Manchester, claiming to know the answer to the infected, as well as protection and shelter. The group decide to go, along the way stockpiling at a local market, and drive through a tunnel in one of the most tense scenes in the entire movie. It's really cool, I love this scene. Especially when you hear the footsteps get progressively louder and hear the screeches from the infected.
I can see them, they're coming! Yeah.
They move around from place to place until they reach an abandoned blockade. Stupidly, Frank gets angry at a crow for cawing, and instead of throwing a rock or a stick to shut it up, he decides to stand underneath a rotting, infected corpse, shake the barricade, and gets a single drop of infected blood in his eye, basically sealing his fate. He turns, the military group arrives and kills him, and they take the group back to a fortified mansion, where the leader of the military group tells Jim that the answer they have is to wait until the infected starve out, then use any female survivors that come around to breed them and to keep the human race alive. Damn. Jim gets knocked out for trying to help Hannah and Selena escape, and he's soon in the company of another one of the military group's defecting soldiers, who tells Jim that the infection is actually quarantined to just Britain and hasn't spread across the world yet.
They quarantined us. There is no infection, it's just people killing people. He's insane!
They are led to a forest to be killed, but Jim manages to escape when one of the soldiers gets distracted. He then goes on a revenge rescue mission to save Selena and Hannah in one of the most kick-ass plots of revenge. He kills off the soldiers one by one until he finally saves Selena, who thinks he's infected because he kills the soldier holding her hostage, violently and grunts like a madman throughout the entire attack. He slowly goes towards her, and before she could strike him down, he says,
"That was longer than a heartbeat."
They share a kiss and—
Oh, you shit! Son of a bitch! Why?
But I thought he was buying you.
I was kissing her. You stole me.
pretty funny scene. They then escape, but oh shit, the general's in the back seat. He shoots Jim, and Hannah backs the car up to the mansion's front door for the infected members of his soldiers to grab him and beat him to death. The scene then keeps cutting back and forth between shots of Selena trying to revive Jim and keep him alive. 28 days later. Jim, Hannah, and Selena survive and make a message out of bedsheets that spell out hello, while a passing plane spots it and they smile, showing hope and ending on a nice note. After this movie finished, I wanted a sequel immediately to see what would happen to Selena, Jim, and Hannah, but the sequel turned out to be after the events and followed two kids instead. Anyways, this movie is still one of my favorite zombie movies, and also one of my all-time favorite movies in general. I really like the opening shot of London. Empty streets and the shops surrounding Jim make for an excellent opening. The post-it board or whatever he finds in the middle of the street filled with people asking if they've seen this person shows the eventual downfall and distress that the event put on the city. The characters of Jim, Selena, and Frank are all fantastic. Murphy's portrayal of Jim is one of my favorites he's ever done. He plays him at first as a man whose world is destroyed, and he goes about it trying to live in a world that is now out to kill him, and he turns from a scared running survivor into a badass by the end of the film. Naomi Harris's Selena is also great, being this tough, no-nonsense survivor who does what needs to be done in order to survive in her new world, even if it means killing people she knows, like with Mark. Frank is just a lovable father figure. He's funny, has charisma, and is just fun to watch, especially at the supermarket scene where he chooses wines and stuff, telling Jim about how to pick the best one out of the bunch, just like a father would. The comedic times, while few and far between, are pretty good as well, especially when Jim kisses Selena and Hannah is so whacked out on pills to notice and thinks he's biting her. And of course, the show-stealing infected. Whenever you talk about 28 Days Later being a zombie film, the most prominent question that is always raised is they're not really zombies. And yeah, I mean, it's described at the beginning that the infection just gives you uncontrollable rage.
Infected with what?
Rage.
The fact that you never see them eat bodies that are already dead, like the mother and baby in the burger joint, and the fact that they run and seem able to move their joints and stuff without problem confirms this. So it's kind of hard to even call it a zombie movie when they don't show the stereotypical zombie traits. You know, the beginning of rigor mortis, the not slow movement, and the fact that they still have a bunch of their skin on their body and no viscera hanging out. But the world in chaos, an infection that wipes out an entire town and city, they attack in groups and so on, makes this more than worthy of being called a zombie movie, in my opinion. Now, the negatives are a few as well. Like when Selena and Mark are discussing how the power went away for the whole city, but when they find Frank and Hannah's hideout, we clearly see them having working lights and, damn, they really need a calendar because it ain't fucking Christmas with all these lights and shit. I hated Frank's death because it could have easily been avoided. He should have just walked back to the car and closed the door, or even just ignored the crow. Or throw a rock or a stick like a normal person would have. But no, you just had to pick on that one crow that was eating an infected that was hanging precariously over the wall that you just so happened to shake. Come on, man. And the worst of it was Hannah's acting. Jeez, even when she wasn't stoned, she acted like she was. I mean, I haven't seen any of her other work, the actress Megan Burns, so maybe she's okay. Oh, this was her last role. Well, shit. Her acting wasn't that bad, but some of her lines and delivery was just, eh. But all in all, this movie is good. The characters, the infected, the setting, the infected racing through the streets, screeching. It's just a fun little horror movie.